Thank you for clicking on this video. Today I'll show you how to make procedural mold in Blender. Through this video, I will outline how I made the material you are seeing on screen now. If you learn anything, please feel free to like the video. It is very appreciated. Any feedback in the comments is also welcomed. Anyway, let's go into the video. Create a Voronoi texture and change the values from 3D to 4D and F1 to smooth F1. Also play with the scale and notice how the W value changes the formation of the texture. To invert this value, change 2 min to 1 and 2 max to 0. Changing from max makes it look like the white values are growing out of the black values. Add a value node and name it age. Plug into from max. Select these two nodes and press Ctrl J to frame them. Name the frame whatever you want. Create a float curve node. Give it an S curve. The goal here is to create an obvious circle in the middle of this hazy gray area where we will place the green nasty part of the mold. Let's start by creating the bumpy middle section. To do this, I'll create a noise texture, increase the scale, add some detail, roughness, and a bit of distortion. Now add a map range node and change the from min value to add contrast to the texture. Select these and create another frame. Name it Bumpy Bits. Give it a color. Now let's create the hairy bits. Duplicate this frame and everything in it and name the frame Hairy Bits. Increase the distortion and change the from min. Also, invert the value like we did before. Mess with from min and from max until it vaguely looks like hair. If you squint, it does, and that's good enough for me. The goal is to get to the point where we can add these two values together, but we cannot do that now. We will first need to isolate the bumpy section and the hairy section and then add them together. Let's start with isolating the bumpy section first. Create map range, plug the float curve output into the value, and increase from min and decrease from max until we isolate where we want to see the bumpy bits. Now add a math node set to multiply and plug this map range value into slot 1 and bumpy bits into slot 2. Now we are showing the bumpy bits where we want to. Create a frame called Isolate Bumpy Bits. Now duplicate the frame with everything in it and name the new frame Isolate Hairy Bits. Now we can invert the map range like before and duplicate the multiply. Multiply this value by the float curve to maintain the dark areas where mold has not yet grown. Now we can add these two outputs together to combine them. If we have the same value in from min and from max plugged into the map range nodes, they will perfectly add on to each other. Create two value nodes. Name one from min and the other from max. Make from max slightly greater than from min. Create a math node set to multiply after the add node to boost the values. Plug this multiply into the alpha socket. Now let's add a color ramp and plug this multiply into the factor. In the darker areas, we want it to be gray and white, and in the white areas, we want to create a gradient going up to aqua green and green. The more natural color variation you add to the shader, I find the better it looks. After this, I like to add a math node set to greater than. and then plug that between the multiply and the alpha socket. With this, we can create a hard cutoff to the hairy bits by slightly increasing the threshold, which really emphasizes its shape and makes them look spindly. Select these three nodes, frame them, and name it something like color factor and alpha. Press Ctrl T on the Voronoi texture. Change the vector output from the mapping node from generated to object. Add a value node and plug into the scale of the mapping node. This node will control the scale. Label it scale. Create a bump node. Plug this into the normal. Plug isolate bumpy bits output into the height. Bring the strength down a bit, but I personally like it pretty strong. To get the specular, we can plug the isolate hairy bits output into the specular and connect a multiply node to it to control the intensity. Select the multiply node and create a frame called specular. Add a displacement node. Plug in the map range from isolate bumpy bits into the height. Make sure displacement and bump is turned on. It looks weird. Bring the scale way down and set the mid-level to 0. Select all of the nodes and press Ctrl G to group them. Create inputs for the group called scale, age, W, and exponent. Plug color into the output, and specular, bump, displacement, and roughness. Tab out and name the group fungus or mold. Plug these outputs into the principled slots. Now we can control the shader outside of the group. From here on, we can make any additions that we want. You can add a location and rotation from the mapping node to further control the placement. Duplicate the noise texture and map range from bumpy bits. Don't forget to plug in the vector. Play with these settings. Add a mix group to blend between these two noise textures. The nodes are on screen now. Use vector to control the blending. Please give the video a thumbs up if you learned something, and subscribe if you want. Thanks for watching.